classes, and they're going to share the Jagannath pastimes. So the first one would be Nandini Mataji. She'll be sharing the pastimes, and then after that, her husband Param Prabhu, he will share some of the pastimes, and then after that, Vidya Mataji will share the pastimes.
Ramu, make it stand.
I'll pass it on to Nandini Mataji.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
I'm holding the mic probably after 4 years, so I'm not sure how good I'm going to be. It's all thanks for giving me this opportunity, and it's all by the mercy of Guru Maharaj.
Hold it closer. Yeah.
Sorry, that's the reason I told. I'm not familiar holding it for last 4 years. Okay. Thanks for giving me this opportunity to just give a glimpse or a snapshot of His Holiness Bhakti Purushottam Swami, who has come all over from India. Who has given his, who has spent time with us for 3 days, and he was one of the, he's this, he's the first senior most devotee of Jayaprathaka Swami Maharaj, and it's His Holiness Jay Bhakti Purushottam Maharaj has given classes about none other than the Lord of the Universe, and he is Lord Jagannath. Jagannath ki
Jai.
Thank you. I would like to start with the normal way we say the shloka. I would like if you can, we can say together. And correct me if I'm wrong in any way, because I'm still learning. And hope you all forgive all the offenses that I'm making today. Om Ajnana Timirandasya Jnananjala Shalakaya Shakshururunmilitam Yena तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः नमो विष्णुपदाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्त स्वामिनिति नामिने नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देशतारिणे वांछा कल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्येव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः श्री जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 रामा राम रामा हरे हरे I got to know a shloka which Bhakti Purushottam Swami has taught. I'm not sure if you would be knowing about it. I would like to say them, and probably if you can repeat them. Nilachala Nivasaya
Nilachala Nivasaya
Nityaya Paramatmane
Nityaya Paramatmane
Balabhadra Subhadrabhyam
Balabhadra Subhadrabhyam
Jagannathaya Te Namah
Jagannathaya Te Namah
This verse is very simple. Nilachala Nivasaya. Nilachala is like the blue. Nivasa is the person who is residing in the blue mountain, who is Lord Jagannath himself, and he who is giving his darshan along with his brother and sister Balabhadra and Subhadra Maharani, and we give our humble obeisances to all of them. And this was one of the good things which I could learn a shloka for Jagannath. Sorry for having notes in my hand, because there were a lot of names which was covered during the lecture which I could not memorize. So apologies for that. The first day class is what I'm going to give a glimpse of it, followed by the second day class by Param and the third day class by another devotee, Vidya Mataji. In the first day class, it was completely covered in the glories of Lord Jagannath himself and Jagannath Puri, with a lot of cute pastimes, and that is when I could understand why Jagannath's eyes is so big, why his eyes are red, why his hands are stretched out. So there were a lot of reasons behind all these pastimes. As you all be knowing, there are like four important dams in India. One is, the first dam is Badrinath, and second is Ramnath, Dwarakanath, and Jagannath. As for the four yugas, the dams, that is where the god is coming and representing in different dams. In Badrinath is the time when he came in Satyuga, where he meditated, and the Ramnath is where he came as Ramchandramurti, and third is Dwarakanath, where he, Lord Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Lord Krishna, he himself came down, and Jagannath is the fourth Yuga, which is Kali Yuga, where we all are very fallen soul, where we need his merciful blessings to all of us. A question to all of you. Is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu an avatar of Kali Yuga, or Jagannath his avatar of Kali Yuga?
Ma'am, not both. Because Maharaj said the Lord doesn't take avatar in Kali Yuga.
Perfect. He's correct. No. God doesn't take avatar in Kali Yuga. That is the reason why his name is also another name for the Supreme Personality of Godhead is Triyuga. He just takes avatar in only three yugas. He doesn't take. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is not an avatar. He came as devotee to this world. And why Lord Jagannath is, he's a god of Kali Yuga. But why he's not been considered as, because he is so merciful God, and let's see why he's not been. Lord Jagannath comes to this world on the prayers of Lord Brahma. Brahma's whole lifetime is called Para, and his half lifetime, which is 50 years, is called Parardha. So in the first Parardha, Jagannath is in the form of Neela Madhava. That's where the shloka we learned, Neela Madhava. And in the second Parardha, he is in the form of Chatur Dhamma Murti. And Chatur Dhamma Murti is Jagannath, Baladev, Subhadra Maharani, and Sudarshan. What happened after Dwapara Yuga is that every yuga there should be an annihilation. And Brahma is the one who has got all the responsibility to create the whole universe again. So he was very wondering, like, even if I create yuga, people are going to still suffer. Why should I create yuga then? So he went to Lord and he asked, why should I do this process again? That is when Lord told to Brahma that you go and meditate in Brahmagiri, where I'll appear, and if people who take my mercy, if they take my darshan, they'll be delivered from all sins, not only that they have committed, and also the sins that they're going to commit in the future. And that is the merciful God, Lord Jagannath. Following his instruction, Lord Brahma went to Nilachal Dham, which is in the banks of southern sea near Odisha, which is around 20 to 23 kilometers from Puri. And that place is called Brahmagiri or Alarnath. So that is where Brahma meditated, and he wants to bring Lord Jagannath to this world. Same time, everybody was happy, because when you get darshan of Jagannath, you're going to get the deliverance from this world. But there was only one person who was not happy. Any guess?
Yamraj.
Perfect. Yamraj was the one, because his duty will be, he cannot fulfill his duty. So that is when Yamraj went and prayed again. He went to the top of Nilachal Dham. That is the Purushottam Kshetra. And that is where Lakshmi Narayan was sitting. And he said, like, I've given a boon to Brahma that if he prays and meditates on me, I'm going to come in the form and give merciful to everybody. But at the same time, if you're saying that I should not give mercy. And what Yamraj was praying is that you should not come to this universe. If you come to this universe, everybody will get delivered by your darshan, and nothing would be, there will be no job for me. So what, he has to satisfy both of them. So at the end, what Lakshmi Narayanan told is, I would be, myself and Lakshmi, we both will go into the sand and we will get hide there. But I can't stop my devotees. My devotees are more stronger than me. They'll definitely find me one day. And then they will, I cannot stop from giving mercy to people. And Lord Jagannath was being found by the king, Indradyumna Maharaj. So like this, that is how Jagannath was that came into Kali Yuga. And as we all see that he is the most merciful god of this universe, same is with his darshan and same is with his Rath Yatra. So hope you would have seen Rath Yatra in Sydney. Lord Jagannath is the only deity who comes out of his Singhasan and who comes to the Rath Yatra. There is no altar or something that comes in, there is no other deity. The main god, he himself comes out of the Singhasan, he comes and gives darshan. And Lord Jagannath is the only god who is like very friendly to everybody, and that's what Bhakti Purushottam Swami was telling. He has seen the Pandas. Pandas are the people who do pujas to Jagannath. They, during Rath Yatra, he has seen people who are leaning on Jagannath. There are, he has seen people who were hugging his belly and sleeping during the Rath Yatra when they were decorating. That is how Lord Jagannath is. We have no other god here in this material where we can go and physically hug. That is how we have got a lot of homes where we pray Lord Jagannath. And now, how to satisfy Lord Jagannath? The only thing which you can do to satisfy is feed him, keep on feeding him. He is very fond of food. And how we satisfy Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is sing and dance. That is how we satisfy Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. There are two gods which Prabhupada has introduced to us. One is the god who is eating, one is the god who is dancing always. So feed him, feed him, feed him, every time feed him. In that way we can also have like lot of prasadams. So as I said, the unique merciful god of this Kali Yuga is Lord Jagannath. Now, what is another important thing in Jagannath Puri is prasadam. Have you all tasted prasadam of Jagannath Puri? By God's grace, yes, it's unimaginably plenty and plenty of prasadams. They normally cook chappan bhog for the god, which is like they offer to the god in a lot of mud pots. And what is the story behind this? Why do they offer so much food to the god? Is there any reason why? Has the god asked for? Let's see why. What happened in ages ago is everybody was getting prasadam of Jagannath, but except for one lady. And she was? Any guess? Parvati. That's right. She was Parvati. Then she was very worried. I didn't get prasadam. I'm not so much great soul that I'm not getting prasadam of Jagannath. And that is when he himself came into Parvati Mata and asked, like, why are you so sad, Mata? Like, I'm not getting prasadam. I didn't get the prasadam. But what I need is, okay, I'll give you prasadam. Then Mataji, Parvati Mata said, no, I don't want prasadam. I want all my children, which is all of us, the human beings, the living creatures of the material world. I want all my students, all my children to have prasadam. And that is why we have got so much prasadam cooked for Jagannath. And then it is first offered to Bimala Devi, who is the deity in Jagannath Puri of Parvati. They offered the prasadam to Vimala Devi and then the prasadam is served to everybody. Now, when seeing prasadam, there are a lot of other different, there is no, a lot of rules that is there in Jagannath Puri. And rules are something like, if a kid is going for a urine in the temple, they have a maha cleaning happening. At the same time, there will be pandas who will be having chewing pan. So there are a lot of, there is no proper rule, or like the rules are very weird. Why? Because all the rules are made as per the devotee's wishes. I would like to thank for this opportunity, and I would like to hand over this mic to Param so that he can continue about Jagannath. Thank you for this. Jagannath ki!
That's very nice. I know devotees, you know, they start praising Lord. They go on, you know, it's unstoppable. Yeah, I agree. But please mind the time, like, you got 2 minutes. Please, otherwise, you know, it takes a long time.
Okay. Hare Krishna. So I've been asked to deliver it in the 1 hour lecture in 2 minutes, so you can understand how it should be. Maharaj, Bhakti Purushottam Swami covered was four dhams, which Mataji, Mataji has already spoken about. Badrinath. The name came because the Badri is berries. So berries, so Lakshmi, Mataji came, Lotus Lakshmi came as Badri or a berry tree. And for the Yuga Dharma of Satya Yuga, which was Tapasya, Lord Badri Narayan came to show everyone how to do tapasya, how to do austerity. Next one was Dwarakanath, as Mataji also spoke about it. So it's in the bank of Gomati River, and the Lord is Dwarakadish. Ramnath is where Lord Ramchandra is worshipped, Lord Shiva. So that is a very architecturally beautiful place. And then is Jagannath. Now before I go into Jagannath, what Maharaj spoke about was when we go to Puri, Puri Dham, there are other places which we need to cover, some very important places. So they are actually based on the four kshetras. As you know, Lord Jagannath has four, Shankha, Chakra, Gada, Padma. So each of them, Lord Vishnu has those. So each of them is what each place denotes to. So Lord Chakra Kshetra is Bhuvaneshwar, that is Lingaraj temple, it's Lord Shiva's temple, where that's Kshetrapal. So whenever you go to Puri, you need to pay obeisances to Lingaraj and then go to Jagannath Puri. So that way Lord reveals Puri better, is what Maharaj said. Padma Kshetra is Konark temple. There is a beautiful story about it. I am going to skip it, but if you get a chance of what the story is, you know, listen to Maharaj's lecture and you'll get better understanding. But it's about Sun temple. Gada Kshetra is Jajpur, there Diraja Devi is worshipped, and in Shankha Kshetra is where Lord Vishnu placed his conch shell. So that is, in that that area is actually 10 crores in area, and there is a center which is called Shankha Nabhi. Apart from this, I just came through it. Panchatirtha, when we go there, we have to sprinkle ourselves with some holy waters. So there are five rivers or sarovars which are important. Indradumna Sarovar, Markandeya Sarovar, Shweta Ganga Sarovar, Mahadadi Mahasagar, Rohini Kunda, and Narendra Sarovar. And apart from that, there are some deities who protect Lord Jagannath. There are eight Shambhus, eight Devis, and eight Mahavis. In Panchashiva, there is Jomeshwar Mahadev. He is actually the one who performed the marriage of Lord Jagannath to Lakshmi. Then is Markandeya Mahadev. This was based on the pastimes of Lord Markandeya when he was attacked by Yamaduta, Lord Yama. So he hugged Lord Shiva, that the Shiva Linga bow broke into pieces. Then Neelakantha Mahadev, the bank of Indradumna Sarovar, Kalpa Mochana Mahadev. Kapal Mochana Mahadev is basically head of Brahma, which gets stuck to the hand of Shiva. As a, when he passes by Jagannath Puri, the head falls off, so the curse falls off. So this signifies that, you know, it's the purest of pure places. So if you have all sins or any sins, you come to Puri and you kind of are removed of all the sins. Apart from that, he also covered Mahavir, but I'm just going to keep it subtle and simple. We heard about Kanpata Hanuman, Hanuman who has a ear and who hears his Lord Jagannath's father-in-law's noise and tries to shield or protect them from the noise entering the temple. Bedi Hanuman, Hanuman which was tied with chains. Interesting pastimes. So that's it from my side. Hare
So, if you have your group members, you can introduce. Yeah, bring them.
Hare Krishna. So, continuing about the Jagannath pastimes. Holiness Bhakti Purushottam Swami Maharaj told about why Lord Jagannath Dham is the topmost Dham. So he told about two things, like both Dham wise and also Lord wise, Lord Jagannath is topmost. So the Dham wise, he was saying about we have the three different types, Aishwarya Dham, which is Dwaraka, and Madhurya Dham, which is Vrindavan, and we have the Audharya Dham, which is Navadip Dham. We have all three in Puri Jagannath, which is the Gundicha temple is the Lord's birthplace, so it is considered as Vrindavan, and the Puri temple by itself is considered as it is Aishwarya Dham, similar to Dwaraka. And we have all the places like Tota Gopinath and Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya place and everything, which is the representation from the Audharya Dham, which is the magnanimity of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu shown. So Dham wise it is topmost, and also the Lord wise it is topmost, because we could see Lord Jagannath taking service and also rendering service. Like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is rendering service and Jagannath is taking service, so it's complete in that way. It is topmost in every aspect, and there are many pastimes in which only one pastime I would like to share, which is the Gita Govind pastime. Lord Jagannath likes to hear Gita Govind every day, and many of you would know about Gita Govind. I'll make it very short to say Gita Govind is the poem which describes about the intimate pastimes of Radha and Krishna. It is written by the devotee called Jaidev Goswami. So you would have known about the story, how Jayadev Goswami was writing it, and when he was about to write the line where Krishna was asking the Radharani's lotus feet, he was asking to put on his head. So Jayadev Goswami was thinking, oh, how could Krishna take Radharani's lotus feet and put on his head? So he was little skeptical, and he said, maybe, okay, I'll take a bath and then write it later. So in that break, his wife has cooked the prasad and he was waiting. Suddenly he could see one more Jayadev Goswami coming quickly and saying he forgot to write on line, and he wrote the line which he was thinking. And the line was, which was saying Krishna was asking the Radharani's lotus feet to put on his head. So that is written, and he quickly had prasad and then he went. And then the real Jayadev Goswami is coming, and he saw his wife eating prasadam without him, and he was like, oh, you are eating without me, what happened? You already came in, you wrote a line and then you add the prasad. And then when he saw, it was actually the line is written, and he identified that Krishna himself came and he wrote the line which the Jayadev Goswami was thinking about. So it is that is Gita Govind, and it is very dear to Lord Jagannath, and he wants to hear it every night. And the pastime, there are many pastimes related to that. One important thing is when the pujari noticed Jagannath the next day morning was with torn clothes, and all the things in the garden was stuck on his dress, and they were scared, like somebody came into the temple and they were disturbing the altar or something. But I'm just making it short. So the king had a dream, and Jagannath said, nothing happened to me, it's just that the gardener's daughter was singing Gita Govind in the night when she was picking brinjals, and I went hearing and I didn't remember where I was, so I was just going behind. And the king was worried that every day if Jagannath goes out hearing Gita Govind and if he's not returning back, what will happen? So then he wrote Gita Govind in the the brass plate, and he ordered that every day the same devotee, she'll come and sing Gita Govind for Jagannath. And now every day it's happening now in Puri Jagannath, and they have written it, and they are singing that song every night. So that is very glorious pastime, which was very dear to us as well. So I thought of sharing that. Thanks for giving this opportunity. Hare Krishna.
Anandai Gopinath Prabhu, do you want to? Where is Anandai? So I would request him to